So very good afternoon class. Today I will be teaching about nasal obstruction. So this topic is for BSc third year. So nasal obstruction, simple, nasal meaning comes from the word nose and obstruction means any blockage. So agar koi blockage ho jate hai hamari nose ke andar, then we can call it as nasal obstruction. So the definition is, it is a sense of blockage within the nose or difficulty in breathing out of one or both the nostrils. ठीक है, तो अगर कोई ब्लॉकेज हो जाते हैं हमारी नोज के अंदर, then it obviously cause breathing difficulty. ठीक है, it can cause breathing difficulty from one nostril or from both the nostrils. So this is nasal obstruction. Classification, it is classified into physiological, okay, alternating or physician dependent. Number two, it can be bilateral or unilateral, means both the nose, there are obstruction in both the nose or there is obstruction in one nose. Okay, so in one nose, it is unilateral. Obstruction in both the nose, it is bilateral. Next, partial or complete. And last is continuous or intermittent. Then coming to the another classification is the nose. Okay, if there's any obstruction in the nose, obstruction in the sinuses, and the nasopharynx. Okay, so any obstruction in these we can consider as nasal obstruction. Causes, now one is deviated nasal septum. Okay, so this is a deviated nasal septum. Normally hamari nasal septum straight ho jate, okay, it is straight, but in some patient it is deviated. Okay, you can see there is a curve. Okay, so this is deviated nasal septum. So this is one of the cause for nasal obstruction. Foreign bodies, okay, any foreign bodies which is blocked inside the nose, large adenoids, okay, adenoids which are very large or they are swelling, so that also can cause nasal obstruction and infection. So these are some of the causes for nasal obstruction. Coming to the clinical features, ultimately automatically the patient will have difficulty in breathing. Okay, so nose will not, they will not be able to breathe from their nose, isliye mouth se breathing karna padega. So breathing difficulty, mouth breathing, dryness of the oral mucosa, because they are breathing so much from the nose, from their mouth, the mouth is dry, so there is dryness of oral mucosa, and associated problems including dry cracked lips. Okay, so the lips also will be dry and cracked. Patients with chronic nasal congestion often suffer from sleep deprivation. Okay, they are not able to sleep properly because of the nasal congestion, blockage at the nose, due to difficulty maintaining an adequate airway while lying flat and during sleep. Next, diagnosis, history collection, physical examination, CT scan, MRI and X-ray. So these are done, CT scan, MRI, X-ray is done to detect if there is any deviated nasal septum or if there's any foreign object or if there's any enlarged adenoids. Now coming to the management, okay, so nasal steroid spray, next, that is given to reduce the inflammation, oral leukotriene inhibitors such as Montelukast, antibiotics for the treatment of infection, antihistamines can be given to reduce allergies, functional rhinoplasty, okay, reconstruction and reshaping of the nose because the patient is having deviated nasal septum. So you will reshape and reconstruct the nose. And septoplasty. Septoplasty is reconstruction of the deviated nasal septum. Now next is the nasal polyps. Nasal polyps you can see here. Okay, so these are polyps. These are nothing but soft, painless, non-cancerous growth on the lining of nasal passages or sinus. So these are called as polyps. Okay, so these are painless and they are non-cancerous and they grow on the lining of the nasal passages. So because of these nasal polyps, they are causing obstruction in the nose. Therefore, patient is not able to breathe properly. Or poaching of mucous membrane lining the nose is also called as nasal polyps. So these are outpouching, okay, so they are coming out like this. Here also these are outpouching mucous membranes which lines the nasal passage. One of the causes is because of allergies and because of poor blood supply. Next, clinical features. Patient will have nasal obstruction, they have a difficulty in breathing, mouth breathing, cracked lips, dry mucosa, dry oral mucosa, anosmia, rhinorrhea, frontal headache, and mouth breathing. Diagnosis, same history collection, physical examination, nasal endoscopy. Okay, we will have a viewing of the nasal mucosa to check for any polyps. Nasal smear will be done, X-ray and CT scan to check, to view for the, to detect if there's any polyps. Management, okay, since because it is allergies, one of the main causes will include antihistamine, steroids, antibiotics to reduce infection, polypectomy to remove the polyps, and endoscopy sinus surgery. So these are some of the managements for nasal polyps. So today, I hope you've understood. We have done about nasal polyps and we have also done about the nasal obstruction. So thank you, class, for today.